Tim Weaver, chaplain at the community of Rockhill, and I welcome you to the service of Rememberance. This past year has been a year that none of us will forget. A year of worldwide COVID pandemic. A year of quarantine and isolation. A year filled with losses too numerous to count. Losses of loved ones with no way to grieve. No funerals to be held, no hugs to be given or received, no one to cry together with. Too much grief and too few ways to process that grief. Today is our day, our way of remembering your loved ones who you entrusted to our care, an honor and a privilege that we take very seriously. Death is difficult. Dealing with death takes time and energy. We at the community at Rock Hill offer this service as a way of helping you as families and friends to grieve the loss of your loved one. It is also a chance for us to grieve as well. During this service, we will hear a song of hope and comfort. We'll listen to a reading. We'll offer you a time to remember and reflect via a PowerPoint presentation. And then I'll have a closing story. The YouTube presentation that you're watching will be posted on this website for 2 weeks. In the book, My Name is Asher Lev, Kain Potok writes of a young boy walking home from the synagogue with his father one day, and as they walked, they discovered a dead bird on the sidewalk. And they talked about how that everything that's born dies. And the son wonders why animals and people have to die and don't live forever. There was a long period of silence and reflection by Asher's father, and then his father said to him, "Son, so life would be precious. Something that's yours forever is never precious anymore." We recognize today that our loved ones are not ours forever. And recognizing that, we become aware of how precious life really is. I invite you now to listen to a word of song, a word of invitation and hope and comfort, sung by 3 residents here at the community of Rock Hill: Pam Coons, Dorothy Laufer, Marilyn Bielhauser, and Marilyn Hampshire is playing the piano for them. Blessing wrote, "Grieving is not about forgetting. We will always carry our grief with us. But grieving allows us to heal, to eventually remember with love instead of pain. It is a sorting process. Grief is the way that loss heals. One by one, we let go of the things that are gone and not coming back. And you mourn them. And one by one, you take hold of those things that have become part of you, some of them because of the one you've loved and lost. And you begin to build and celebrate again."
I'm Carol Delancey, the Executive Director here at the community at Rockhill. And on behalf of the staff here, we are grateful that you have joined with us in this service of remembrance. We wish to honor the memory of your loved ones along with you. It was truly a privilege to care for each one and to have had the opportunity to know them during the time that they were a part of our Rockhill family and community. Our thoughts are with you today as we celebrate their lives and remember them together. And now I'd like to share walking with grief. Do not hurry as you walk with grief. It does not help the journey. Walk slowly, pausing often. Do not hurry as you walk with grief. Be not disturbed by memories that come unbidden. Swiftly forgive and let Christ speak for you unspoken words. Unfinished conversation will be resolved by Him. Be not disturbed. Be gentle with the one who walks with grief. If it is you, be gentle with yourself. Swiftly forgive. Walk slowly, pausing often. Take time. Be gentle as you walk with grief.
Will you join me in prayer together? Eternal God, who changes not in life or death, be our assurance as we mourn our loved ones today. Give us relief from grief and anger. Open our hearts to your never-failing love. Spirit who guides through all life, be our peace through and in this mystery of death. Give us your comforting presence so that death will not be defeat, but a meeting with the God we love. Jesus Christ, who passed from death to life, be our triumph over suffering and death. Give us sustaining grace and assurance as we await your coming again to receive us unto yourself. Amen. Next, we will have a slideshow of each of the residents who have passed in this period from April the 1st, 2020 through March the 31st, 2021. We have a picture where possible, along with their birth and their death dates, and when and where they arrived at the community of Rockhill. There will be music accompanying the slideshow.
Thank you.
In these past few minutes, we've taken time to remember your loved one. If you're feeling grief and sadness, that is normal. We offer this experience in remembering your loved one to help you in the grieving process. Death is a real and important part of life. It is a difficult part of our journey. For many of the persons we remember today, death was a gift, relieving them of a tortured existence. For others, no doubt, it came unbidden and unexpected. I offer you this story in closing. An oyster is a soft, tender, and vulnerable animal. Without the sanctuary of its shell, the oyster could not survive. But oysters must open their shells in order to breathe water. And sometimes when an oyster is breathing, a grain of sand enters into the oyster's shell and becomes part of its life from that point on. Such grains of sand cause pain. But an oyster does not alter its soft nature because of this. It does not become hard and leathery in order not to feel pain. It continues to entrust itself to the ocean, to open and to breathe in order to live. But the oyster does respond to that grain of sand. Slowly and patiently, the oyster wraps that grain of sand in thin, translucent layers until over time it has created something of incredible value in the place where it had been most vulnerable to its pain. A pearl might be thought of as an oyster's response to suffering. And not every oyster can do this. But oysters that do, however, are far more valuable to people than oysters that do not. Sand is a way of life for an oyster. If you're soft and tender and slim on the sandy floor of the ocean, making pearls becomes a necessity if you are to live well. Disappointment and loss are part of every life. Healing starts with the realization that our loss, whatever it is, has become part of us. And it has altered our lives so profoundly that we cannot go back to the way life was before. Something in us can and needs to transform such suffering into strength. My prayer for each of you is that you will know the comfort of friends, and most of all, the healing touch of God's Spirit. For God has promised to be with us always. In Christ, we have one who knew sorrow and grief, who wept in the face of death, and in the end demonstrated power over death. Today, the same Christ is alive and standing at the right hand of God in heaven, living and reigning and making intercession for us. This is our faith, and this is our hope. May this hope and this faith sustain each of you in the days, in the months, and the years ahead. Thank you for joining us for this time. May God's presence and God's peace be with each of you. Go in peace. Amen.